So Bev, color the language a little bit. Let's get away from special needs. Tell me what's happening in the world.
Sure. And what I like to share, I actually learned from Jenny Levy, who is one of our Integrate for Good board members, and she lives with an intellectual disability and some serious medical, some health concerns. And she told me that she does not like the word special. And I grew up using the word special. I spent 25 years working as a school-based occupational therapist in special education. So I was a coach with Special Olympics. So special was just something I would say all the time. And Jenny, you know, lucky for me, shared her perspective. And she said, you know, I don't like the word special. I'm like, oh, that's interesting. You know, can you tell me why? Because I never saw that, you know, I saw other, like, we don't use words like mental retardation. Like there are certain words we don't use, right. But special is a word that we use all the time. And I said, you know, please share with me your perspective on that. And she said, when you call me special, other people don't think they're special enough to be my friend, to ask me to walk around the mall, to hire me, to, you know, just to be with me, to just do everyday things. So when I'm labeled special and they see, you know, maybe a job coach or a direct support professional or somebody alongside me, they think, oh, somebody must be specially trained to interact with that person. And that word special, she helped me understand, does in some ways become a barrier. So out of respect for Jenny's perspective, and because she is one of our valued board members, I took it out of my vocabulary because she educated me. Now, does everybody feel that way about the word special? Of course not. But we refer to people by their name. One time Jenny was doing a presentation with me and it was on disability etiquette. And someone from a company said, you know, what should we call you? Do you like diverse ability, special needs, special ability, disability? She said, you can just call me Jenny. And that is what I find that most transition age students and adults want, is they want what everyone wants. They want to belong. They want opportunities to work and to socialize, as Nikisha said. So sometimes we get caught up in the jargon, but I feel it's more important just to, you know, create opportunities in our community so people can get more fully engaged and ask people, you know, just be open. You know, I don't want to offend you. You know, what, you know, we try to avoid that terminology and treat people as people.